What is up, you guys? Brooke here. So I've been seeing this little trend going around AuthorTube lately, and I wanted to jump on board that trend because it just sounded oh so dreamy. And that is to describe our author and publishing dreams. This was never a tag. I think that is so funny that it was never even thought of as a tag. Lindsay Puckett was the one who came up with this idea of talking about our author dreams. And then Kev Landia saw it and he wanted to talk about his author dreams too. And then it kind of turned into a sort of thing to do. And I thought, yeah, I actually have not gone over my author wishes and dreams with you all. And it's a good topic to discuss, especially in 2020 where hope seems to have died. But no, we are not going to kill the hope yet, guys. We are going to bring it back. We are going to keep our hopes and spirits alive and talk about our dreams. Damn it. So let's do that today. Let's talk about what my author dreams are. I feel like I'm like a Disney character right now. I will say that I want to separate this video into two different segments. One will be my realistic author dreams, and then the other one will be like fantasy dreams. And these dreams may not come true, and that's okay if they don't come true, but I am wanting to talk about it anyway because, you know, they're dreams. Even if they're not very attainable, I still want to discuss it with you all because it's just fun. So first, let's go over my realistic author dreams. And my first one is pretty much like what I just truly want the most. And that is to be a full-time author. I want to have it to where I don't have to work for anyone else besides myself. I will work for my characters, but I do not want to have another type of, I don't know, it would be such a dream to just be on my own and to work for myself. Whether that means I be single and I'm a full-time author, or if I am a full-time author while also married to someone, which I will say it would be a lot easier to be a full-time author while I am married to someone, because then I could hopefully use their insurance. That'd be a lot better. That'd be a money saver. Ever since I was a little kid, I wanted to write for a living, which whenever I was a little kid, I didn't realize how hard it would be to write books for a living. But now that I am older and wiser and doing AuthorTube, I am seeing that there is more attainable ways of writing full time, and that's with self-publishing, which is my second realistic dream for being an author, is that I want to be a self-published author. Of course, I have done the whole querying agents back in the good old days of whenever I was like 19 and 20. I had queried agents a long time ago trying to get traditionally published, and that just didn't happen, which is fine. You guys did not want to see what I was trying to query agents. It was not the best of work and was really, really crappy. But as time has moved on and as time has shown more of a realistic light for authors that self-publishing is a thing and that it's here to stay and isn't going away, I am knowing that this is what I want to do. I'm wanting to self-publish my own books. I've seen people who have done it for a living. I know people who do it currently for a living and they make good money at it. I just need to make a backlist. If I can make a backlist of books, if I can get my projects and my books out there, then I think I could be a full-time indie author. I think I can do it, and it's a dream of mine to do it. So this is realistic for me, and that's great. I want this to be a realistic dream of mine, and I think that this could eventually happen if I just work. If I work for it, I think I can do it. And so with being an indie author, I am wanting my dream to be where I eventually publish 2 to 4 books a year. Dream-wise speaking, I would prefer 4 books a year, at least 4 books. That would be the dream. But if we're talking realistic dreams here, I'm gonna say 2 to 4 books, realistically. Once I get in the full-time author game and I just keep books coming out, I would love to keep up with this every single year. But yes, a realistic dream is to publish 2 to 4 books a year, but a bigger realistic dream is to publish more than 4 books a year. But yeah, 2 to 4 is a good, nice, dreamy spot for me. And this one's another dream of mine. This may be realistic or it may be more fantasy dream-like or whatever, but I would love to have it to where 2 characters of mine that are in love have a ship name. The ship name idea I kind of stole from Laura, but I have always wanted to have that. I've always wanted to have like a Delana or a Stelena. Delana though is my forever ship. Like, oh my gosh, what was that sound I just made? That was like very demony. Or if I had multiple love interests going on in the story, I'd love to have my own version of Team Edward or Team Jacob. I love teams for rooting for them when they're not sports. I'm not a sports person, I'm a romantic interest person and I like to root for them. So yes, ship this idea, please, because I love this idea. This is a dream of mine for sure. And my last realistic dream of mine, this one is kind of not so realistic, but then maybe it could be, I don't know. I would love to be a USA Today best-selling author for one of my books. I think that'd be amazing. I think that's more attainable than a New York Times best-selling author. I mean, I'm not gonna be all like, I can do that, but I mean, it's a dream of mine to try and do that. Once again, I think it could happen if I just work hard enough for it and if I just am improving my writing over time to have it to where enough people want to buy whatever book that would sell that would get on USA Today. So that'd be amazing if I could have that happen. Okay, so the next one is fantasy dreams. These dreams are no longer going to be realistic. There's actually not that many fantasy dreams out there for my author dreams, but I want to put these out there anyway because they are what really like makes me daydream during the day. These are the things that I look out of a window and I will look up at the clouds and I think, wouldn't this be absolutely lovely if this happened? So I'm gonna mention that typical one, that typical dream that all of us authors think about, and that is to turn our books into like movie adaptations or TV show adaptations. This one is typical, but it's typical for a reason because that'd just be badass. To see my characters in like real form would be epic and it'd be so cool. If I had to choose between movie or TV show, I think I'd like to do TV show, but it really depends on the series or book that I'm doing, honestly. It really depends on if something could pull off being a show where they kind of have to make up more stuff to add more because, you know, it's a TV show. They have to keep it going longer. But I have to say that I really would want to have control and a say in the music of the show or the movies. I am such a movie soundtrack person. I love movie soundtracks and I really believe that music can make or break a movie. I mean, would Star Wars be such a big hit if it didn't have John Williams' epicness? I don't know. Give me a good movie soundtrack and I will be humming it while I'm doing the dishes or I will be listening to it as I'm writing. Wouldn't that be the coolest thing ever if I had a book turn into a movie and then I got to listen to the movie soundtrack from my book adaptation while I was writing more books in that same series? That's amazing. I just now like thought of that and that's so like, wow. My second author fantasy dream would be if I had a lot of money from my books. If I had a lot of money, I would buy me some type of cafe bookstore thing. Give me a coffee shop that says Passmore Coffee. Isn't that just great? Because my last name is Passmore and it's like, hey, pass me more coffee, you know? Does that make sense? Or Passmore Books, that works too. And I could have it to where you buy coffee and books in the same place. And I'd also love it to be where there's an area of the coffee house where writers can go and write. And it is a no talking allowed room sort of place. And there's outlets everywhere to plug in your laptops. And please buy my future books so that way I can make this happen. Just kidding, I'm sorry. And for my last author fantasy dream is to, this one's like really out there, but oh my gosh, it'd be amazing. If I had enough money from my books, then I would buy me lots of homes all across the states, or I guess North America. I'd buy me homes in different areas of the states and I'd make them be Airbnbs. So that way I'd be getting money coming in for those homes I bought. But whenever I was ready to have some writing time away from my family, away from home, and get my mind in a more creative atmosphere, then I'd hop on over to whatever house I wanted to go to that I owned, whether it be in New York City, that's a place that would be amazing to have a home in, or New Orleans, oh my gosh, wouldn't that be amazing? Or Cozumel, because give me an ocean to write by and I will be satisfied. Or Colorado, because every author needs to have a nice area with snow all around you to write that cozy book. All I'm asking is for 4 homes that aren't in Oklahoma, boring Oklahoma. I need 4 new places to go to for whenever I am ready to have a creative getaway for writing my books. Here's the plan. I would go to New Orleans to write my books and to have my own experiences in the French Quarter and do my own thing. And then after a deadline was due, after I had gotten my deadline over, then I'd have my hot husband bring my adorable kids to New Orleans, and then we'd go about the town. I really think that that would be the biggest dream, is to have all of these like vacation getaways that I can write in. That honestly is the thing I think about the most, like fantasy daydream wise. That is the thing that I go, wouldn't that just be perfection in life? Okay, so that was all of my dreams for author and publishing stuff. And I always thought that all of those dreams, whether they be realistic or fantasy dreams, I always thought that that would just be like the ultimate author life if I had any of those, really. So yeah, I really hope that you liked this video. Please let me know down below if you can relate to any of these things that I had said, or if you want any of these things, or I don't know, or if you already got your movie deal going for your book. And if you liked this video, feel free to give me a big thumbs up down below. I'd really appreciate it. And also, don't forget to ring that bell down below, so that way you can stay notified for whenever I post new videos. And also, don't forget to subscribe. That took me the longest time ever to ring this stupid bell, but it's not stupid, it's wonderful. It's a Tower of Terror bell. And thank you all so much for stopping by today, and may the words be with you. Bye.